I'm just showing you guys. I'll keep it there. So if you guys want to make it, and like from the phone,
and
like
I have a pencil.
So yeah.
Here.
I don't know where it went. No, where did it go? I have no idea. But yeah. Oh, here. So first, you're gonna need some scissors. We're gonna make an eraser. And an eraser, it can be like this type of eraser, or these type, or this type. So first, you're gonna
cut one
that you don't use into a small piece like this. If you want to make it smaller, then you can, but I'm not going to. Then you take a nail file. Then you take a nail file and try to like make it smooth. Some of these I'm not gonna say. Okay. So as you see, it's really smooth. And then you're gonna set the ends. So I smoothed it. And yeah, now we're gonna paint it.
And then we have Santa right here.
Yeah, now we're gonna paint it. So yeah, here we go. Well, I'm not gonna paint it because then it's not gonna work. I don't think, but yeah. So I'm just gonna leave it, and it actually works.
Are you gonna take a shower?
So yeah. So with these, you can, where's my scissors? Okay, here it is. Okay, so you can cut to where right to where the thing ends, then you'll be left with this. You can also make like a little choker if you want. If you want to make a choker or necklace, you just cut this a little snip on the back. Take your LPS and then wrap it around like a little scarf or a choker. There's many colors you can do that with, like purple. So yeah. Okay, so with this, you can just like cut. I'm using this one for an example. You can cut like this small piece so it fits the perfect size of a little LPS. Okay. So now we. You can file it if you want, but yeah. Okay. So now what we're gonna do is just take a piece of paper. We're gonna make So now we're gonna make an LPS computer. Move all this to the side. So let's get started. What you will need for this is a piece of paper. Or a colored piece of paper, or a patterned piece of paper. Scissors, tape or glue stick, and a pen or a pencil. Optional. What's optional is you can have paint, or a colored piece of paper, or a patterned piece of paper. So let's go. I also forgot. You will need a ruler too. So yeah. So you will need a ruler. So now let's begin. So first you need to get your ruler and then just cut off and then just place it down, of course. And then take your pen or your pencil and underline what you need. How big or wide you want it to be. So I want to make this wide. So now you're just gonna make a big computer screen, just like that. And you just wanna cut it out. Okay, so it should look like this. Something like this. Now what you're gonna do is take your piece of paper or a colored piece of paper and just trace it out. If this is only if you want to do a colored piece of paper, and if you don't like wanna do a, if you wanna do only a like regular piece of paper, then you can skip this step. But yeah, now you just wanna cut it out. And if you want to, you can make another one just like this. But I just made it so that this is the keyboard. So yeah, and you could take a white piece of paper to this if you wanted. Like you can do this if you wanted, and then put the keyboard. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. But yeah. So now, what you want to do, if you want it colored on the back, then just color it with the, you know, paint. So yeah, once you've done that, you just want to take this and measure it to be the exact same length as this one. If it isn't, then you could just cut it out to be the exact same shape. Or you could just leave the keyboard or the part of it, like you could just leave that part slightly bigger. So yeah, so I just cut mine out. So now I'm just gonna take a piece of paper to this. Yeah, so now I just took a piece of paper. You could take double-sided tape, would be best, but I'm just taping it, and cut, if you want to, cut off the excess, but you don't have to, so cut off the excess. Then what you want to do is put piece of paper on top of it if you would like. So just like this. And it's okay if it's not perfect, it doesn't have to be. And then the back would look something like this if you have colored paper or something. So yeah. Now what you want to do is take your keyboard and you want to put your brain like slightly in back, and then glue it or tape it, whatever you have. If you don't have double-sided tape, you just want enough so that you can like hold it. So don't make it too long, just enough, but just enough so you can like hold it in. Okay. You just wanna close it up like that so it can stay very well. Do that, and you can take a piece of tape for the front of it. So I'm gonna do that real quick. Okay. So when you close it, open it back up easily. Okay. So now you just want to write all of the like space key, bar, and all that stuff. So yeah, we're gonna do that. Okay, so once you've done that, now you just wanna pull the picture if you want. So yeah, I'm gonna fill in the picture. Sorry. So now I'm just going to fill in the picture. So yeah. You could also put a boy computer. Yeah. If your character is a boy. So this is what it should look like. You can add a mouse to it. So yeah, bye guys.